It is Let's Talk Arts and Entertainment on WMAY. I'm checking in once again with Mark Gifford. We talked last week, actually live on air, about several of the things coming up. And of course, one of the things that's been coming up, talking with him and Gus and other people about the Dual Piano Christmas Concert, a favorite of course, the Dual Piano Concerts. Everyone loves to see them and a wonderful Christmas show to boot. And so Mark Gifford's joining me once again. How you doing, Mark?
Hey, I'm doing great. How are you?
I'm fine. I'm doing great. It's, it's getting pretty close to Christmas.
The clock is ticking.
Yeah.
For all of us. Yeah, very busy. Yeah.
It's very busy times, but it's good. It's good to be busy.
I'd rather be.
Yeah.
And the pandemic year totally proved that.
Yeah, no, it did. It absolutely did. Yeah, so very good. So the show is coming up this weekend, and it's selling very well. And if you guys haven't already gotten your tickets, I don't know what you're doing watching this or listening to it. You should be going to get them already, because it is always going to be a wonderful show. I haven't seen it yet, of course, because it hasn't happened yet, but every show, as you say, is very different. So we talk a lot about the shows, but if by happenstance someone is maybe not maybe they're saying Dual Piano, I kind of remember what that is. Give people a little taste of what people might see at a Dual Piano concert and hear.
Hello, guys. With a couple of concert grand pianos for a couple of hours of fun. It's a little bit like back in the 60s when it was Ferrati and Teicher that did double piano concerts. So this is not the bar hoop-de-doo show. This is proper concert. But in that is a great deal of all of your favorite Christmas songs. We do improvisations on everything we do. Everything that we do is arranged by the two of us. So it's always our own fun. We're just having a blast playing, and we take as much of the Christmas music as we can and jam it into 2 hours for you for your enjoyment for the season.
Yes. And it's all sorts of Christmas music. It is, traditional, new, mixes of some songs, I'm pretty sure.
We like to mix things together a lot. Usually because it's not what the audience is expecting. And so therefore our concert provides them with surprises. And when we come up with these ideas, it's when we look at each other and we're surprised that we know if we're surprised with the idea that everybody in the audience is going to be surprised by it also.
Yeah. Well, it's, and there's all sorts of those surprises in the shows, including mixing up and some, especially the good, wonderful, and with those surprises and things. One of the things that you'll see at these concerts, it's called Dual Piano, but there is sometimes more than piano. There's sometimes voices. There's sometimes percussion, wind instruments. There's all sorts of things but it still is the two of you, the two pianists playing, but all sorts of different things. What sort of things might people possibly, you don't want to give too much away, but things people might see at a concert such as this?
Well, this year we're going back to the basics. It's just Damien and me.
Okay.
We don't have any special guests joining us this year, but percussion always happens.
Yes.
There's always something that shows up that maybe you're not quite prepared for. And so we'll have the two pianos, but we're bringing some other stuff in for the sheer fun of it. And then this year we're putting some more of the modern and the classical and blending the two together in songs and just having a great time doing it. Just so.
Yeah. That's wonderful. That is so much fun, because there are so many, there are just so many possibilities with that, with all the, because there is no shortage of Christmas music from modern day to since
century
Christmas,
old.
Centuries old. And the two of you playing it is going to sound wonderful as it
well,
tends
and then,
to.
You know, the piano is a rather ancient instrument also.
Yes, it is.
So, but we have 2 9-foot Steinway concert grands that literally were delivered to the Hoagland 15 minutes ago.
Wonderful.
And oh, the that's tuner great. Comes in tomorrow morning and spends all morning tuning those pianos and getting them ready for us. And tonight we'll be there and we set the lighting and the sound and get everything ready to go. And then tomorrow night it's kabang.
Yes. And you guys have been doing this for a while. We can talk about that soon. But I just want to say, if you have not heard these pianos, the acoustics of the theater, it is amazing. It is truly wonderful. Yes. You guys have been doing dual piano for quite a while now. What year are you guys in now for this?
We're finishing up our 9th year, Kevin.
Wow, 9 years.
9 years. We haven't been at the Hoagland all 9 years for the holiday show, but this is 6 or 7 or something like that. But yeah, Damien and I are finishing up our 9th year together.
Wonderful. Well, we hope you keep doing it because it's so much fun. It's fun to watch. And I mean, you guys have fun. You can see it. You guys having fun playing up there. And
we're having a conversation. We just let you guys in on it.
Yeah. Yes. And so it is, it is a good time. There's so much that goes on, musically, comically. But you guys really have to see it for yourself, and you have to, of course, listen to it, of course, while you're there. And it's just a wonderful, all around great experience. Mark, how can people get tickets to see this production?
They can call the Hoagland and reserve tickets that way, or they can get online at hcfta.org, hoaglandcenterforthearts.org, and mm-hmm. literally you can hand pick your seats.
Yep.
And choose exactly where you sit, exactly where it is, and pay for that all online. We'll have walk-ins for all three of the concerts, but it's this coming weekend, Friday night and Saturday night at 7 p.m., and then Sunday afternoon is at 2 in the afternoon. And they're both, all three of them are very, very popular, and the tickets are going well, so don't dawdle.
Yeah, and there may be walk-ins available, but if you're sitting here listening and you're like, I'm not sure. If you're not sure, just go ahead online and get them. And
I will tell you this.
Take away the...
There are some friends of mine that have lost loved ones this year.
Yeah.
And the pandemic and all of that goes with it. And literally one of them said to me, we've bought tickets for the concert because this is going to be our... set us in the mood for Christmas.
Yeah.
And I went, you know what? I will be honored that you're there. That will be great. And
yes.
So this is kind of that kick to get going before the next weekend.
Yes, absolutely. So you can get those tickets online. You can call the box office and some might be available when you walk in. But Mark, you and Damien break a leg, some fingers, hands, wrists, whatever. And
as long as you don't break a string.
That'll be an expensive snap. That'll be.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, that would be devastating.
But I know you guys handle those instruments with the utmost care and all the musicality that goes along with it. So can't wait to see that show. It's going to be wonderful. We'll be talking soon, I'm sure, all sorts of different things coming up. But thank you once again for joining me, Mark.
You bet. Thanks for inviting me, Kevin.
Thank you. So let's talk arts and entertainment on WMAY.